Hi, it's me, Dr. Prasad Pudhilam. I did my master degree from University of Mysore with first rank, then continued my Doctor of Philosophy, PhD, from VTU Belgaum. For past 15 years, I've been teaching chemistry and applied chemistry for PUC, that is pre-university, UG, as well as PG students. During this tenure, I could able to publish more than 24 academic textbooks with ISBN number. And I have been member of Board of Studies and Board of Exams for two reputed universities. Right now, I'm on YouTube with my YouTube channel, My Intuition. This is free coaching classes for in chemistry, as well as coaching classes for 10 plus 1, that is first PUC, or 10 plus 2, that is second PUC. If you share this information to the students or their parents, it will be more useful for them. Or if you are a student, please watch this video completely. Subscribe my YouTube channel, give your valuable feedbacks, or if you have any doubts in the comment box given below, or to the WhatsApp number which is displayed in the screen. So this particular class, it is for second PU, 10 plus 2 chemistry, unit number 10, haloalkanes and haloarenes, and it is class number 1. Importance of haloalkanes and haloarenes. So you know, more than 3,900 organic halogen compounds were identified present in natural or naturally available organohalogen compounds are there, such that say a potato, it can produce chloromethane, or a termite can produce chloroform, or many vegetables produces bromomethane. And it estimated that more than 5 million tons of chloromethane is being produced from biomass, which is far higher than that of man-made haloalkanes or haloarenes or organic organic halogen compounds. Then many drugs, say like chloramphenicol, which is used for the treatment of typhoid fever, which is available naturally as well as synthetic drug also be prepared. And our body produces hormone, iodine containing hormone known as thyroxine, and its deficiency causes a situation known as goiter. It can be treated with the thyroxine tablet containing thyroxine, which is a haloalkane. Another haloalkane or another organic halogen compound, chloroquine, which is used for treatment of malaria. Another organic halogen compound, haloptane, which is used as an anesthetic during surgery. And these halogenated compounds or halogen containing organic compound, they exist in environment as they have higher resistance towards the breakdown by soil bacteria. Now, what are haloalkanes or haloarenes? So we know alkanes and arenes or aromatic hydrocarbons. If any one of the hydrogen or more than one hydrogen atoms are replaced by halogen atoms, the halogen atoms are fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodide. So if hydrogens are replaced with the corresponding halogen atom, we'll get corresponding haloalkanes or haloarene. Okay, so presented here. So we are getting a haloalkane as well as a haloarene here. So this is haloalkane, or we call it as halomethane. If it is bromine atom, we call it as bromomethane. Okay, likewise, if this is a chlorine atom, we call it as chlorobenzene. So here, if you consider the carbon atom containing the halogen atom, in case of haloalkanes, not haloalkenes, haloalkanes means the molecule containing only covalent bonds, no double bond or triple bond, no pi bonds present. So here this carbon atom in haloalkane, it is sp3 hybridized, whereas in haloarenes, the carbon is sp2 hybridized. That means it forms three covalent bond and the fourth one, that is a double bond. Classification. Haloalkanes can be classified, haloalkanes or alkyl halides can be classified based on the number of halogen atoms as monohaloalkanes, or say dihaloalkanes, or trihaloalkanes, and if more than three is there, we go for polyhaloalkanes. Like that, arenes, monohaloarenes are there, dihaloarenes are there, and even trihaloarenes are there, and more than that, we have to give the name polyhaloarenes. Okay, the second type of classification, which is more important one, based on the carbon halogen bond in which the carbon, whether it is sp3 hybridized or sp2 hybridized. Okay, if it is sp3 hybridized, three classes are there, like alkyl halides or haloalkanes, that is a general case, allylic halides and benzylic halides. So alkyl halides, that is the simplest one, which can be further classified as primary, secondary or tertiary based on the carbon to which the halogen atom is connected. So here the carbon containing the halogen, it is connected to only one more carbon atom or one more alkyl group, therefore that becomes primary. Whereas the second case, the carbon is connected to two more alkyl groups, which is not hydrogen. Hydrogen is separately presented here. So these two are not R dash and R double dash are not hydrogen, then it becomes secondary. It should be carbon. If connected to carbon, then it becomes secondary. If three alkyl groups are there to the carbon containing the halogen atom, we call it as tertiary. Okay, so that is alkyl halide or haloalkanes. Allylic halides are a type in which the halogen containing carbon, not that carbon, the next carbon to which it is attached with a sigma bond, the second carbon atom contains the double bond. Okay, the halogen containing carbon, the next carbon, if it contains a double bond, we call it such type of molecules are, such type of haloalkanes or haloarenes are allylic type. Okay, arenes, it is difficult. Say the methyl group or the alkyl group which is attached there, it contains the carbon, the next carbon contains a double bond. Okay, so these are allylic halides. So here it is a cyclic structure, cyclohexene actually. So it is an example for allylic halides. The third category with sp3 carbon, that is benzylic halides. Okay, when the word benzyl comes, we remember the structure, benzene structure. So here benzene structure is there, but benzene molecule is there, but the halogen atom is not directly connected to the benzene or the benzene molecule. It is connected to some alkyl group only. So benzene molecule is there, therefore the name benzylic. Okay, so it's an example given here. It may be a primary benzylic halide or secondary or tertiary. Okay, so secondary case in which it's a R dash and R double dash, any one of that R, if it becomes hydrogen, any one of that become hydrogen, then the halogen atom is connected to a carbon which is connected to two more carbon atoms. It becomes secondary molecule or secondary haloalkane. Or if both the alkyl group R dash and R double dash are alkyl group only, say example methyl group, it becomes tertiary. So that is classification based on carbon which is sp3 hybridized. Classification of alkyl halide in which CX bond carbon is sp3. If it is sp2, okay, two types are there, vinylic halides and aryl halides. So vinylic halides in which the halogen atom containing carbon atom is having the double bond. Okay, previous case we seen the allylic group in which halogen atom containing carbon, the next carbon is having double bond, whereas this case the halogen atom containing carbon itself is having a double bond. Okay, so example is given, a representation is given. Okay, so halogen containing carbon having double bond, even if it is a cyclic structure also. The last one, that is aryl halides. Aryl halides, that is benzene or aromatic, not only benzene, any molecule which shows aromatic nature, you can call it as aromatic, not only benzene. Say example, benzene only if I consider. The halogen atom is directly connected to the benzene molecule. Okay, so say it is given the example. Okay, so the example is given. Okay, the halogen atom is directly connected to the benzene ring or the benzene derivative and benzene containing other substituent also. So it is a toluene, second molecule, that is a toluene. If we can call it as 4-halo toluene also. Okay, now nomenclature. Nomenclature, we know there are two types, common names and IUPAC nomenclature. In earlier days, when there was no much organic compounds were prepared or synthesized, people used to call them with the common names. But as the number of carbon atoms increased in the organic compound, or more number of organic compounds got prepared, then the common names got confusions. Different countries, they started giving their own style of names to them. Therefore, later IUPAC nomenclature was introduced so that a common that time it becomes a common to all. Okay, so everyone can follow. So earlier days it was used as common names in which some terms like in normal, ISO, NEO, secondary and tertiary terms were used. How they use that terms that we discuss here. I'm not giving the direct halogen, organic halogen compound here. Haloalkanes are not given, just how the names are given. Say this is a molecule with a hydrocarbon with a four carbon atoms. So four means that is butane. Okay. So earlier it was called as normal butane. Why so? Because butane, the four carbon atoms can be arranged like this also. Okay, this is 2-methyl propane. Okay, so the four carbon atoms can be arranged like this also. Then also it is four, then it is a something about butane only. Therefore, the name, a common name was given as isobutane. And a molecule of this structure, if it becomes a group, say here the attachment or the halogen atom or any other attachment is going to happen to this carbon atom, which is actually the third carbon atom. Okay, then it becomes isobutyl group. Okay, something, some name you have to add at the end based on the attachment at the extreme right side of this. Then with a pentane, so this is a five hydrocarbon containing five carbon atoms and there are no double bonds present here, therefore it is pentane molecule with the IUPAC nomenclature. Okay, so the common name it was normal pentane because this type of normal, I would say, five carbon atoms can be arranged like this also, which was given the name like iso. Okay, so like isobutane, this will become isopentane. And the group with isopentane in which the fourth carbon atom, so this CH3, here it becomes CH2 single bond connected to some molecule, say halogen if it is halogen only. Okay, then it becomes isopentyl group. Okay, so this is the isopentyl group. Now with the five carbon atoms, one more structural possibility is the rearrangement of carbon atom. You can arrange it like this. Okay, so it is 2,2-dimethylpropane. So here, while giving the common name, they used to give, they use the word neo. Okay, so this will become neopentane. And the group in which any one of the CH3 or CH3 are like now, same CH3 now, because contains only one carbon and four attached to that. Therefore, if any one of the CH3 becomes a group, then become neopentyl group. Okay, so this is neopentyl group. Okay, if halogen is there, it becomes neopentyl halide. Then with the six carbon atoms, it becomes a normal hexane. Then isohexane and neopentane and neohexane, isohexane and neohexane. Like that, its group even becomes isohexyl group or neohexyl group. Okay, that is about a normal, iso and neo. Now remaining is secondary and tertiary. Secondary and tertiary, say molecule CH3, CH, CH2, CH3. What's not exactly okay. So CH3, CH, CH2, CH3. So this is butane molecule. Okay. So in molecule containing four carbon atoms, we call it as butane. But the second position, it has got an attachment or a functional group is there. Say, let it be halogen only. Okay. So now this halogen containing carbon, so this carbon, it is attached to two more carbon atoms. Or we can say this carbon atom, it is secondary carbon atom. Okay, carbon containing two more carbon atom. Carbon atom attached with the covalent bond to two more carbon atom, it becomes a secondary carbon atom. Therefore, it becomes secondary methylpropbutyl. Okay, already said it is butyl. Okay, it becomes secondary butyl, SEC butyl, or even we write as S butyl. You can call them as S butyl. Now with the pentyl, it becomes secondary pentyl or S pentyl. Okay, now tertiary carbon atom. To explain tertiary carbon atom, I took 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon atom. Therefore, it is again butyl only with a common name. If you consider, or it becomes a 2-methylpropyl group. Okay, so here the carbon atom here it is tertiary because it is connected to three more carbon atoms. Therefore, it is a tertiary carbon atom. Therefore, we call it as tertiary butyl or T-butyl with five carbon atoms in which the carbon is tertiary. It's attached to the functional group. So we call it as tertiary pentyl. Now this tertiary pentyl or the pentyl molecule, they also called as tertiary amyl. Okay, so these type of naming when they come, when it comes in common name, then people started getting confused with the structure of the molecule. Then the IUPAC nomenclature was introduced. I will take some examples. Okay, CH3, CH2, CH2Br. It will consider both common name as well as IUPAC nomenclature. The common name for this molecule, it is a normal hydrogen, normal structure, or say the bromine is attached to first carbon atom only. It is not iso or secondary like that nomenclature. No need to give. It is normal propyl bromide or normal propyl bromide. It is normal propyl bromide, and it is IUPAC nomenclature. It becomes 1-bromopropane. Second molecule example, CH3CH CH3Cl. So this is isopropyl group. Therefore, it is isopropyl chloride. Isopropyl chloride is the common name. IUPAC name, it is two second position. Second carbon contains chlorine, so it's 2-chloropropane. Next example. So again, this is iso group. Okay, therefore it is 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon atom butyl. Therefore it is isobutyl chloride. That is the common name. Or IUPAC nomenclature, we can call it. We have to give more importance to the halogen atom here. So this is carbon atom 1, 2, 3. Therefore 1-chloro-2-methyl-propane. So 1-chloro-2-methyl-propane. More examples. Okay, aromatic halogen compounds or haloarenes. So this is its common name. It is bromobenzene. Okay, bromine and benzene. Its common name was bromobenzene. IUPAC nomenclature, no much difference. It is bromobenzene only, because here the double bonds, if it is there, we may confuse that we have to give the double bond position and all that. That means position 1, 3, 5 contains double bonds. Therefore, 1, 3, 5 triene like that. If we cannot give it with a benzene, because the double bonds are, even though while writing the structure we give the double bond, but actually the double bond nature, it is not there. It is half double bond or partial double bond, and we have to represent it with a circle. Then when we write the benzene structure, cyclohexane and a circle inside, but still we will represent the three double bonds to show some reaction mechanism in that. Therefore, it's a IUPAC nomenclature also, benzene only. We cannot call it as the benzene molecule as 1, 3, 5 cyclohexane triene like that. We cannot give. It is benzene only. So it is bromobenzene. IUPAC nomenclature also bromobenzene only. Okay, so next example, which contains 2-bromine molecule, dibromo. Okay, so if you consider 1-bromine atom, first bromine atom containing carbon, okay, that will be the parent molecule. And the next attachment, okay, so this carbon atom, carbon containing the bromine, the next nearby carbon atoms in benzene ring, that is known as ortho position. The very next carbon atoms, that is known as meta position. And opposite to that, the carbon with the functional group, that is known as para. So ortho, meta, para, or ortho, meta, para. So here, dibromo, but they are with ortho positions to each other. Therefore, it is ortho dibromo benzene. For IUPAC nomenclature, we can call it as 1,2-dibromo benzene. Okay, so ortho dibromo benzene or 1,2-dibromo benzene. Next example, here it is, I said this is a meta position, ortho, meta, para positions. So the bromine is at a meta position to each other. Therefore, it is meta dibromo benzene. For IUPAC nomenclature, 1,3-dibromobenzene. So it is a meta dibromobenzene or 1,3-dibromobenzene. Okay, another example, 3-bromine atoms, but it is connected to meta position each other. But we have to we'll call it as a symmetric structure. Okay, this is symmetrically arranged. Therefore, the word was used as symmetry, SYM. So this is symmetric tribromobenzene or 1,3,5 tribromobenzene as the IUPAC nomenclature. So symmetric tribromobenzene is the common name. 1,3,5 tribromobenzene, that is the IUPAC nomenclature. More examples. Okay. Okay, only IUPAC it is given here, giving here. Okay, so this molecule, the parent hydrocarbon contains three carbon atoms. Okay, like this also you can consider as parent hydrocarbon. Anyhow, we consider the maximum number of carbon atom in the main chain. It is main chain containing the halogen atom. It is three only. Therefore, so it is propane molecule. Propane molecule, now position one has to be given to the halogen atom because it is a function, that is a functional group here. Okay, so halogen atom, the carbon should be given position one. Therefore, 1, 2, 3, like that it goes. Therefore, position two contains two methyl groups. Therefore, 1-chloro, 2,2-dimethyl propane. So it is 1-chloro, 2,2-dimethyl propane. Another example, this is position two, no confusion here. Position two contains bromine, therefore 2-bromopropane. Okay, so the next category of common name when we start was given, that is geminal halides or vicinal halides when it becomes dihalo substitution. Two halogen atoms are attached to the based on the nearby carbon atom, whether it is attached to nearby or on the same carbon, like that. Geminal and vicinal, gem or vis, common name were used to give. So this is ethylidine chloride and ethyl dichloride, ethylene dichloride. So here the two chlorine atom is connected to the same carbon atom. Okay, therefore it is known as gem dihalide. But at the second case, the two halogen atoms, so chlorine atoms connected to the two different carbon atoms, then becomes vicinal. Okay, so gem as well as vicinal. It's a UPAC nomenclature. It is 1,1-dichloro ethane. Here 1,2-dichloro ethane. Okay, so 1,1-dichloro ethane, 1,2-dichloro ethane, or it is known as ethylene dichloride in common name, also known as vicinal dihalide. The first one, it is known as ethylidine chloride or gem dihalide. Many examples. Okay, so structural isomers of C5H11Br means the molecule containing 5 carbon atoms, 11 hydrogen atoms and 1 bromine. These are the possibilities of isomers, the structural isomers, giving the IUPAC nomenclature. So this is IUPAC nomenclature we are giving. So we have to count the number of carbon atoms, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But position 1 to this carbon, because bromine is connected to this carbon atom. Okay, so here the bromine is attached to the carbon atom. Therefore, this is considered as carbon atom 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 means penta, 1 bromo pentane. Okay, even we can represent, no need to represent while writing IUPAC nomenclature. Here, identified the bromine containing carbon, whether it is primary or secondary. So here it is primary. Bromine is connected to carbon, which is connected to another carbon. So it is primary carbon atom. Second case, here again bromine attached to second carbon atom. If you count from this side, that becomes fourth. That is wrong. So we have to count from this side, 1, 2. Okay, therefore it is 2-bromopentane, and the bromine containing carbon is secondary. Therefore it is secondary. 2-bromopentane and secondary. Third case, that is tribromopentane, and it is again secondary only. So 3-bromopentane, I said tri, no, it's 3-bromopentane and it is secondary. Next example is interesting. CH3 twice, CH2, CH2Br. So here CH3 twice means this carbon, which I indicated with this arrow mark. This carbon atom contains one CH3 in the parent chain. It is connected to a CH3 group in the parent chain, and one CH3 acts as the side group. Okay, therefore a methyl group, CH3 means methyl group. A methyl group is there, but still we have to consider the halogen atom. More importance, preference should be given to the carbon containing halogen atom or bromine atom here. Therefore position 1, 2, 3, 4, and 4 means butane molecule, and 1, 2, 3, third carbon atom contains one CH3 group, extra CH3 group. Therefore, 1 bromo, 3 methyl butane. It is 1 bromo, 3 methyl butane, and bromine containing carbon, that is primary carbon atom. Okay, so next example, CH3 twice CH. Okay, so that means one CH3 is in this parent chain, another CH3 that becomes the side group, and bromine is connected to the second carbon atom. Okay, if you consider from that side, it becomes third. That cannot be given. Bromine has should be given, the carbon containing bromine should be given the least number. Therefore, 1, 2, 3, 4 butane, and second position contains bromine, third position contains methyl group. Therefore, 2 bromo, 3 methyl butane. So it is 2 bromo, 3 methyl butane, and bromine is connected to a secondary carbon atom. This case, next case, bromine is connected to a carbon which is position number 3, 1, 2, 3 from right side if you count. Left side if you count, 1, 2, second carbon itself of bromine is there. Therefore, we have to count from left side of this screen. Okay, so CH3 twice, you have to split it as CH3, C, CH3, Br, CH2, CH3. Therefore, it is 2 bromo, 2 methyl butane. 2 bromo, 2 methyl butane, in which the carbon is connected to the bromine, the carbon containing bromine, it is tertiary nature, connected to 3 more carbon atoms. Therefore, it is example for tertiary carbon atom. Next example, CH3, CH2, CH3, CH2, Br. Okay, so Br is there, and CH3 molecule as the side group. Position 1 is bromo. Position 2 contains a methyl group, butane. So it is a butane molecule only. Therefore, it is 1 bromo, 2 methyl butane. Last example, CH3 thrice C, CH2, Br. CH3 thrice means this carbon contains 3 CH3 groups. So 1 CH3, CH3, C, CH2 containing 2 more methyl group. Therefore, it becomes 1 bromo, 2, 2 dimethyl propane. So it contains only 3 carbon atom in parent chain. 2 methyl group becomes side groups. Therefore, it is 1 bromo, 2, 2 dimethyl propane. So it is 1 bromo, 2, 2 dimethyl propane, which the bromine containing carbon is primary in nature. Next, more examples. Okay, common names already given. The secondary butyl chloride. Secondary butyl chloride is 2-chloro butane. Here it is CH2CCH3 thrice. That means it is 2CH3 group, and in a straight chain, 3 carbon atoms are there. CH3C, CH3 twice, CH2Br. Therefore, position 1 to this carbon atom only, the carbon containing Br. Therefore, it is 1 bromo, 2,2 dimethyl propane. So it is 1 bromo, 2,2 dimethyl propane. Tertiary butyl chloride. Tertiary butyl chloride means, okay, so here carbon containing 3 CH3 groups, that is CH3C, CH3, CH3. If you consider the longest chain, if you consider this direction only, that means 1C, second 2 carbon atoms, therefore ethane molecule. But if you consider the side groups, what comes to our mind, that becomes the parent chain. Okay, 3 carbon atoms and 1 CH3 to the second carbon atom. Br also connected to the second carbon atom. Therefore, it is actually 2 bromo, 2 methyl propane. Propane means 3 carbon atom. Therefore, it is 2 bromo, 2 methyl propane. Now, haloalkenes. This is an example for haloalkene. Double bond is there and halogen atom is also there. Okay, and both if Cl is connected here or Cl is connected to the other carbon atom, it becomes position 1 only with respect to the double bond. Therefore, it is chloroethene. This is chloroethene, E-T-H-E-N-E, ethene. CH2 double bond, CH2Br. Okay, so now position, if you give, double bond has to be given more importance than that of halogen atoms. That is the IUPAC nomenclature system, in which double bond has to be given more importance than halogen. Therefore, the carbon containing double bond is having more importance. That becomes carbon atom 1, 1, 2, 3. Therefore, 3 bromo prop 1 nene or 3 bromo propene. Okay, 1 in or 2 in. If you give a double bond here also, it becomes 1 in only. Okay, therefore 3-bromopropene. Okay, aromatic with the substitution. Okay, so IUPAC nomenclature you can give as 1-chloro-2-methyl-benzene. So this is 1-chloro position 2-methyl. Okay, when chlorine and methyl comes, more importance is given to halogen. Therefore, 1-chloro-2-methyl-benzene. Or even we can consider this structure C6H5CH3, that is known as toluene. Okay, already chlorotoluene is given there. Therefore, we can consider here as a toluene. If toluene is the parent alkane, parent hydrocarbon, then position 2 contains chlorine. Therefore, even we can call it as 2-chloro-toluene also, or 1-chloro-2-methyl-benzene or 2-chloro-toluene. 1-chloro-2-methyl-benzene or 2-chloro-toluene. Okay, so this molecule, the benzyl chloride, so it's an example of benzyl group, that classification that I already explained. Halogen atom containing, but benzene molecule is there, but halogen atom is not directly connected to the benzene molecule. So here it is, parent chain it is methane, only one carbon atom is there, and benzene molecule is attached as a side group, and Cl is also side group. Therefore it is 1-chloro-chlorophenyl-methane. It is chlorophenyl-methane. Okay, now these are very simple. Methane molecule containing 2 chlorine atom, therefore 2-chloro-methane. No need to give the numbers because only 1 carbon atom is there. Therefore, it is dichloromethane, trichloromethane, tribromomethane, tetrachloromethane, and here it is fluorine atom is there. Therefore, CH3CH2CH2F, 3 carbon atom. Therefore, it is propane. For position 1 construct fluorine, therefore 1-fluoropropane. So these are the IUPAC nomenclature, some examples. More examples, some complicated structures, if give, how to give. This, the structural representation makes us to feel as it is complicated, but we can crack it out. So CH3, C double bond, CH3. So bromine is connected to 1, 2, 3, 4th carbon atom. Total 5 carbon atoms are there, therefore it is pentane molecule containing double bond, therefore it is pentene. And double bond is at a carbon atom 2, therefore it is pent-2-ene. And carbon atom 4 contains bromine, therefore it is 4-bromo-pent-2-ene. 4-bromo-pent-2-ene. Another structure, this is carbon containing double bond. Methyl group is the side group. Bromine is also a side group. The carbon containing double bond has to be given more important. Therefore, position 1, 2, 3, 3rd position contains bromine, 2nd position contains methyl group. Methyl, 4 carbon atoms in the main, therefore it is propane. 4 carbon atoms, it is butane. Okay, therefore it is but-1-ene. The parent chain, parent molecule is but-1-ene. And bromine and the methyl group, if it comes, bromine has to be given first priority. Therefore it is 1, 2, 3, 3-bromo-2-methyl-but-1-ene. 3-bromo-2-methyl-but-1-ene. So here CH3, C double bond, CCH3. Okay, so CH3 at a side group, bromine is a side group, a double bond is there. Positioning you have to count from left side only, because bromine 1, 2, 3 becomes that a double bond goes to the 3rd carbon atom. So here you have to start counting from left side, 1, 2, 2nd carbon atom contains double bond. Therefore, 1, 2, 3, 4th carbon atom contains bromine, and 2, 3, 4, 5, total 5 carbon atoms are there in the parent chain. Okay, this is our observation. Therefore, it is 5 carbon atoms is pent-pentene, pent-2-ene. 2nd carbon atom contains double bond. So, pent-2-ene is the parent chain, and 4-bromo-3-methyl-pent-2-ene. 4-bromo-3-methyl-pent-2-ene is the name IUPAC nomenclature of this molecule. Now next molecule, that is CH3, C double bond, CCH3, BR. You have to count 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon atoms. Double bond contains 1, 2, 2nd carbon atom. Here also 2nd carbon atoms. Okay, so both sides if you count, 2nd carbon atom contains the double bond. Therefore, we have to give more importance to the side views then. Therefore, 1, 2, we have to start counting from the carbon which contains the bromine now. So 1, 2, so position 1 contains bromine, position 2 contains methyl group, position 2 contains double bond, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 carbon atom, that is nepta, eth, prop, bute. It is bute 2-ene, 1 bromo, 2 methyl, bute 2-ene. Another structure, CH3C double bond, CH, CHPR, 1, 2, and 2. Okay, so this is 1 bromo, 2 butene, or bute 2-ene. 1 bromo, 2 butene, or bute 2-ene. Both are the same. Last example, C double bond, CH double bond, CH3, CH2Br. Okay, so double bond has to be given more importance. Carbon 1 contains double bond, therefore it is 3 bromo, 2 methyl propene. Okay, so 3 bromo, 2 methyl propene. So that is the examples. Okay, now more example in which the IUPAC nomenclature is given and we have to draw the structure. How we can draw the structure if a name is given. Okay, so say here, here pentane molecule, then you have to start considering the last parent chain, pentane. Pentane means ANE, that is alkane, no double bond present. Penta means 5 carbon atom. Therefore 5 carbon atom in a straight chain, 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 carbon atom you have to draw in a straight chain with a single bonds. Then you have to go to the first means important substituent, that is 2-chloro. Here it is 2-chloro. 2 means position 2 contains a chlorine. So it becomes 2-chloro now. Position 3 contains a methyl group. So 1, 2, 3, position 3 contains a methyl group. Therefore, this is 2-chloro, 3-methyl. It become pentane. We have to satisfy the carbon's tetravalency by hydrogen atoms now. This carbon only attached to one carbon now. So 3 more hydrogen required. Therefore, it is CH3. So here 3 bond already is there, therefore 1 hydrogen required. Here also 3 bond is there, 1 hydrogen required. Here 2 bonds are there, 2 hydrogens required. Here only 1 bond is there, 3 hydrogens required. So this is the structure of 2-chloro, 3-methyl, pentane. 1-chloro, 4-ethyl, cyclohexane. Cyclohexane, let me draw the cyclohexane first. So this is cyclohexane. Now 1-chloro and 4-ethyl. So any one position is considered as any of this position can be considered as position 1 because all are equal. Okay, so this is considered as position 1. So 1-chloro, that is already given. Now fourth position, 1, 2, 3, 4 already mark is there, so it is easy to identify. So it is 4 ethyl. So ethyl group is CH2, CH3. So this is 1-chloro, 4-ethyl, cyclohexane. A complicated name is given for tertiary butyl 3-iodoheptane. Not so complicated. We'll start with the parent chain, heptane. Heptane means a 7. 7 carbon atoms in a straight chain. 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 7 carbon atoms in a straight chain, that is heptane skeleton structure. Then fourth position contains tertiary butyl group. Tertiary butyl group means a carbon containing 3 more carbon atoms, that is tertiary. Okay, carbon is that is attached to the fourth position. So 1, 2, 3, fourth position carbon, which is a tertiary carbon. So tertiary means 3 more connections to be given. I think it got stuck. Okay, so it 3 more carbon atoms we need to connect to that, and it is connected to the position number 4. So it becomes tertiary butyl structure, skeletal structure. Now position 3 contains iodine group, iodine molecule. Okay, so position 3, 1, 2, 3, this is the position 3, it contains one iodine. Okay, so 4 tertiary butyl skeletal structure is there, 3 iodine already there, heptane skeletal structure is also there. Now we have to satisfy the carbon's tetravalency with the hydrogen. It becomes CH3, CH2, CH, CH, 1, 2, 3, CH, CH2, CH2, CH3. So here carbon already four tetravalency is there, whereas here CH3, and one more CH3. So this is four tertiary butyl, three iodo heptane molecule. 1,4-dibromobut-2-E. Butane, butane means 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And position 2 contains double bond. Okay, so this is for position 2 contains double bond. So position 2 double bond, right side if you count as a position 2 contains double bond. Okay, always giving the structure, we start from left side writing. 1, 2, 3 like that, we'll start writing. That is my method. Okay, you can consider from the right side also, you can consider you get the same molecule. Same molecule can draw. Okay, but my method, I always start with the left side, 1, 2, 3, 4, like that I start. So 1,4-dibromo, position 1 contains bromine, position 4 contains bromine, 1,4. Okay, so bromine attached here also. So 1,4-dibromobut-2-ene skeletal structure is done. Now you have to give hydrogen atoms, CH2, CH, CH, CH2. So this is 1,4-dibromobut-2-ene. 1-bromo, 4 secondary butyl, 2-methyl benzene. Okay, we'll start with benzene. Benzene, I represent with a circle. Okay, benzene with a circle there, that is aromatic nature. Okay, now first substituent, that is 1-bromo. Okay, any one position we take, so we'll take this position as 1. So here 1-bromine, I attached 1-bromine there. 4 secondary butyl, 4 means position 4. So if bromine is connected here, 1, 2, 3, 4, just opposite to that, that is the fourth position. It contains secondary butyl, okay, secondary carbon is there. That means one carbon containing two more carbon atoms. Okay, so two more carbon atoms. So we got a secondary carbon, but it is methyl-prop only. We need a butyl, that means four carbon atoms required. So any one more carbon atom is connected here. You can even connect to the left side also. Okay, so this is the four secondary butyl group. Now we have to satisfy the carbon valency with the hydrogen. Okay, so, I'm sorry, two methyl group, I missed data. So position two contains a CH3 group. Now the valency has to be satisfied with the hydrogen. So this is the structure of a 1-bromo, 4 secondary butyl, 2-methyl benzene. Okay, so APZ nomenclature, that much examples is over. So now we go for the nature of carbon halogen bond. Okay, based on the carbon halogen bond, their physical property and chemical property is determined. Okay, so carbon halogen bond, in which the halogen atom are more electronegative, therefore always in the covalent bond itself, there is a slight shifting of the electron towards the halogen atoms, or this bond, not like a CH bond, these are shorter bonds. Okay, therefore we can say that there is a partial positive charge to carbon atom, partial negative charge to halogen atom, because halogen atom is more electronegative, it has got the tendency to pull the electrons, it will take more electrons from the covalent bond itself towards its orbital. Okay, therefore CX is polar in nature, it becomes a dipole. Okay, so dipolar nature is there, positive charge and negative charge separation is there, not completely, partial positive charge and partial negative charge. Based on that, the physical property with the CF, CL, CBr and CI, that is fluoroalkane, chloroalkane, bromoalkane or iodoalkane, the bond enthalpy decreases. Enthalpy means the energy required to break the bond. So the energy required to break the bond is decreasing. That means CI bond can be broken easily with a chemical reaction than CF bond. CF bond are always, they are stable bonds. Okay, so this is the bond enthalpy, it is decreasing. Polarity also decreases. Like this CI bond, almost the partial positive charge is not there. Partial positive or partial negative charge, it is not there. Whereas the CF bond, it has got a more positive and negative charge separation. Though we can say polarity is decreasing from CF to CI. Bond length and bond enthalpy values are given. The bond length from CF to CI, it is increasing. Example is given with a methyl molecule, fluoromethane. chloromethane, bromomethane, or iodomethane. So you can see the bond length is increasing, bond enthalpy is decreasing. That is because of the nature of a CX bond. Okay, that's all for this particular class. Thank you very much for watching my video. Please subscribe my channel and support. So I'll sign out from this presentation. Thank you very much once again and have a nice day.